Y'all sleep? I tell you what I do. You feel good right now? Everybody feeling good, right? Everybody feeling comfortable?
Stand up.
You feeling comfortable?
Stand up.
Do my favor.
Stand up.
Get up and go to another seat.
Oh, snap.
I want to show you something. Apostle, you see what I just did, right? This is what God is telling us. God is telling us you're too comfortable in the seat you in, so go to y'all on him in the day. See, I'm trying to bring you into a revelation. God is trying to tell you something, because see, some of y'all done got too comfortable in your mess. You okay with how your day go? You okay with what's going on in your life? You just okay in sin. But what God is trying to tell you, I'm trying to get you to move from out of the place that you're in. I'm trying to shake that dust. I'm trying to shake you, but you don't see that I'm shaking you, because guess what you're doing? You done got caught up in your own lifestyle. You done got caught up in you. And so you got to ask God, God, come inside me and get this fire from inside me from burning within. Help me, somebody. Because you see, when fire come, fire supposed to burn up things. But you better understand, when the enemy come in like a flood, all he doing is consuming you. Oh, nobody want to play with me tonight. See, that's why people have problems dealing with prophets. I just want to come in. Let me come in, just preach, have the praise team jump and shout so I can jump and shout, feel good about myself, feel good about what I'm doing, feel good because I got a good cell phone, I got an Apple 6 or whatever, I got my job, I got my regular car, but guess what, I ain't worried about the lifestyle of other people. I'm not being a servant, sitting here telling my story, bringing people back into the awareness that there is a God, there is a hell that you can go to. Nobody want to play like that, because everybody want to go to church, man of God. All they want to do is say, I'm a part of this church, or I'm a part of that church. But guess what? Then they walk right back outside. Then they sit here and talk trash about everybody. Ain't nobody safe in their house. Even the pastor ain't safe. Even the preacher ain't safe. The elect lady showed them not safe. Tell me, somebody, you got to understand that God trying to bring us into a place where we got the awareness of him. We got to see God for what it is. God didn't send us to this earth to be comfortable. God didn't send us. He said, you in the world, but not of the world. See, that's the problem. We got too many people in the church, but not of the church. Oh, you don't hit me tonight. I'm talking about they are, but they're not participating. They're not doing things. And if they do something, they're looking for recognition. They're looking for their name to be called. They're looking for somebody to call their name. But that devil ain't number to lie. I ain't trying to get my name called. I'm just doing what God told me to do. I don't care if it's four people in here. I'm going to preach just like this. I don't care if it's four people. I heard something on the radio the other day, and it vexed my spirit. I don't care how tired I am. I don't care how tired I am. I don't care how I travel up and down the road, man of God. I got to do the work of God. When God tell me to be a servant of God, that means my prophetic never go to sleep. It never go to sleep. If I come in with my own issues, and somebody come in on the verge of sitting here saying, I'm about to throw the towel in, I'm going to sit here and commit suicide. Just the other night, on Wednesday night, I got a text message of a woman sitting in a room with her babies with a knife at her throat. Oh, y'all don't hear me. I had to get on the phone, and I didn't even know who this woman was. And I called the number. I said, woman of God, what's going on? She said, I can't take it no more. I can't take it no more, man of God. I don't know how I'm going to take care of my children. We stand in a room. We ain't staying in a house. We stand in a room. I said, woman of God, this is what I'm saying. I hear what you're saying. I know life is tough. Sometimes your back get up against the wall up against your back. I understand. I've been there. I've done that. But guess what? Ain't nobody, not damn Negro. Oh, y'all better hear me.
Negroette or whatever you want to call her. I'm going to kill myself for. That devil ain't number lie. I want to be lit. Oh, you know what? It kills me when I see preachers stand behind the pulpit and now they're so holy monies. I'm ready to go see God. I be in the pulpit with them. When they say that, I say, okay, time for me to go down here with the people, because I ain't ready to go see him right now. I want to do some more stuff here on earth. God, on him tonight. I understand there's going to be a day I'm going to have to go. But guess what? I ain't going to call that thing out, because the Bible say life and death lies in the power of the tongue. You're going to sit here trying to be so holy and speaking like that. Do you know the enemy is listening? Do you know the enemy hear what you say? See, that's why some of y'all, every time you plan something, it just don't work out, because you put it in the atmosphere too much. If you notice, if you my Facebook friend, I'm always sitting here saying, I speak into the atmosphere that your life will never be the same. Help me, somebody. See, I done came into an understanding that guess what? I can't get caught up with what people are saying. I can't get caught up with what people are doing. I've never seen a bunch of preachers that call themselves preachers, that call themselves leaders. Oh, yeah. Some people say, you're a preacher hater. No, I ain't. Oh, I'm a sin hater. Because how can you preach the word of God and then you go and do the same exact thing? You see here, no. He said, in the last day, men will be lovers of themselves. They'll be boasters. They'll be pipe biters. You never read up there. I always say, I thank God. Oh, I humbly say, because I thank God for everything he doing in my life. He saved this crackhead. Y'all don't hear me today. He saved me from being homeless. He took me out the crazy house 2 or 3 times. Oh, yeah, I done lost it a couple of times. Oh, y'all better hear me now. They done gave me some medication, had me walk around like a zombie. But guess what? Now I got a new medication. Y'all don't hear me tonight. Now I got something new in my life. Now I get drunk every day. Every time I come to church, I'm looking for a drink. I'm looking to get drunk in God. But see, that's the problem. That's the problem. That's the problem. People are looking to get drunk. But what you get drunk on? Because sometimes you can get drunk on self. Sometimes you can get drunk on you. Sometimes you can get drunk thinking you everything in a bucket of chicken and hot wings. But I know for a fact, it's nothing but the grace of God that got me where I am now. And I ain't got time to play with the devil. Some of y'all need to stop being a spiritual garbage can. Spiritual garbage can to people. Ain't nobody should be able to come and tell you anything about your pastor. Ain't nobody should be able to come and tell you anything about your leader. Ain't nobody should be able to come and tell you anything about your spouse. Because listen what I'm saying. You know I'm better than everybody else. And guess what? If you in God, you ain't got to put a tracking device on them. If you in God, guess what gonna happen? God gonna visit them in visions and in dreams. Oh, nobody wanna help me tonight. And guess what? If you doing real bad, guess what? They ain't got to look for you to fall. It's gonna fall in your lap. Help me, somebody. But see, nobody wanna look and trust on God today. You got to ask God on a daily basis. God, take this fire from inside me. God, take this hidden anger from inside me. See, you don't understand. It's sad to be in God 20, 30 years and you still holding. You still holding anger, bitterness, resentment against people who treated you wrong in the past. Some of us, we haven't even forgiven our family member. Help me, somebody. The Bible say when a man is born, he's born a few days full of trouble. Help me, somebody. So what God done, God set some things in order. God set some laws in order. He said when a man is born, that's not a law, but it's a foundational scripture. So that way, when the enemy come in like a flood, you can take that scripture and tear down the stronghold. Am I telling the truth, man of God? So now, he said, oh my God. He said, y'all sitting here looking at me, fanning and all that, got me all mixed up. But now listen to what I'm saying. He said that when the enemy come in like a flood, that the Spirit of God will lift up a standard. So in the last day, men will be lovers of themselves. Or in the last day, men will be boasters. See, that's That's the problem. See, we all want to be somebody. We all want to be somebody in God. See, that's why a lot of us, when we come to the God, when we come to God, that's why we got fear and anger, because we want to be somebody. And you got to understand, God designed man. Every man is designed to have respect due to him. God designed man like that, but God designed a woman. Oh, y'all better hear me. A woman is designed to be loved. Oh, help me somebody. If you ever need a woman to be moved, love her and watch what happens. If you love her, she'll give you everything she got. Help me somebody. Why do you think God called woman or called the church a woman? Because anytime she designed to be loved, if you love a woman the right way, oh, it's nothing. She will withhold nothing from, oh, you better hear me. She will withhold nothing. She will withhold nothing. So if you're in a relationship, doc, and she withholding some stuff, check your love. Check your love. Because if you check your love, you're going to find out that's where your check and balance going to be. Oh, nobody want to talk to me today. Am I talking realness today? Am I talking real today? Am I talking real? Because see, that's the problem. We don't want to be taught real too. We want to tell, girl, you know you're all right. Listen to what I'm saying. We all got issues. Ain't none of us perfect, including the man holding the mic. You heard, did you hear that? Including the man holding the what? Mic.